brain tumor is really defined as a mass that's capable of growing in the brain. And what I think is really important is to understand that not all brain tumors are created equally. You have some types of tumors that are capable of very fast growth, and those might be what we'd call cancerous or malignant types of tumors. And they can either start in the brain or they can spread from the body up to the brain. It's called a metastasis. Then you have a whole series of other types of brain tumors, which are typically benign, meaning they don't spread to other parts of the body, but they can be equally challenging. Things like meningiomas, pituitary adenomas, acoustic neuromas. And they don't grow fast, but they tend to grow in difficult places to get. But we do have good treatments for them. A brain tumor, really any brain tumor, should be evaluated by a neurosurgeon. We don't always treat them surgically, but we're usually part of the team that decides whether they need to be treated in some way. And the ways we treat them are to either, what you might say is doing nothing, but we're not doing nothing. We're watching it closely, what we call surveillance, checking it with imaging, making sure it's not growing or behaving in a way where we wouldn't expect it. If it is behaving in a way where it's getting progressively larger or causing problems, then we have to do something to treat it. Most of the time in the brain, we're talking about either removing it surgically, either all of it or part of it, or treating it with radiation. There's very few tumors in the brain where medications are effective. Those things are starting to emerge, but right now, for the majority of brain tumors, we rely a bit more on surgery and radiation. I think going into the surgery, most of the time I have a pretty good expectation of what the surgery is going to involve and how things are going to look after surgery. I think most people would be sort of surprised by how well people do from brain surgery, especially when you do it all day, every day like we do. It depends a little bit on what kind of tumor we're going after and where it's located. Many tumors, we take them out. You're always going to spend at least a night in the hospital, most people 2 or 3 days. But most people come out of the surgery looking pretty much like they did going into it. So if they don't have deficits where we work really hard to not cause new problems, if they have problems going into the surgery, we work really hard to do what we need to do to undo those problems. We can't always undo them, but you know, most of the time we have a good idea of how things are going to go. Every once in a while, you know, with brain surgery, things can be tougher than we expected, but we work very closely with our intensive care staff, our nurses, our hospital doctors to make sure you have the very best outcome that we can achieve. I'm Dr. Christopher Farrell. My mission at Jefferson is to improve lives.